Hey everyone, welcome to Stories of Architecture. In this video, we will talk about the different type of gardens. So without any further ado, let's begin. The different type of garden. So there are many questions that can come up from this topic, and many questions have been asked in gate architecture related to type of gardens. So let me tell you in what way, what sequence can we establish so that it is easier for us to remember the different types of garden and their definitions and their different properties. So let's see how to remember. I have categorized the different type of gardens that we are going to study in four different categories. These are introduction, where we will talk about the history and design philosophy behind the gardens, then their design characteristics, then the design elements or different things that are used in the design for that particular garden, and then the fourth category is types and examples. Okay, so without any further ado, let's begin by looking into different type of gardens. Okay, so the first type of gardens that we are going to talk about is Chinese gardens. I wonder why the Chinese are in news lately. So let's have a look at the first category, which is introduction. So Chinese gardens are a place for solitary or social contemplation of nature. They are miniature of the Chinese landscape, which is spread all across China. The Chinese gardens try to recreate nature but not duplicate it. They are based on profound observation and deep understanding of nature and abstraction and stylization of existing landscape. Then the Chinese garden's purpose is to celebrate human spirit. Let's have a look at the design characteristics of Chinese gardens. The garden scenes are concealed inside different scenic sections, revealed in a sequence along the path. So whenever we go in a garden, you might notice that there are different views and vistas or particularly scenes. So Chinese gardens are based upon the idea of scenic views, and these scenic views are concealed inside different scenic sections. So there are different sections for each scene, which are revealed along a path. The scenic spots for static and dynamic viewing and lingering observation. So there are different spots for static and dynamic scenes, dynamic viewing. Then every scenic section has own character but unified under one theme. So it's a very difficult thing to achieve. It is not easy to have different characteristics for different scenes, but then everything is unified under one theme. So it is a very interesting thing. Now moving on. So the third category is design elements. There are six main elements. The first one is rock. Rock is valued for its size, color, and texture. It is used as a structural and sculptural part of the landscape. There are dedicated rock gardens in the Chinese gardens. The rocks are used to make artificial mountains to divide space. The second main element is water. It is used to adjust the microclimate in the area. Then it is a contrast to the rigid rock or mountain which is present. Then it provides listening satisfaction. So there is a listening aspect to water. It is not shaped into any geometrical pattern, and there are natural lakes and streams. But the one important thing about Chinese gardens is that there is no water fountain. So it is an important feature which differentiates it from the other gardens that we will discuss. Then the third element is vegetation. There is minimal variety of plants and trees in the Chinese gardens, and each of them have a symbolic meaning. Like flowers such as lotus, peach, and azalea are seen. Plants and trees like pine, bamboo, mulberry, and plum are present. Then another important feature in Chinese gardens is that there are no lawns. So maybe a question can come up that which garden type of garden has no lawns, then it's Chinese gardens. Then the fourth element is pathways. The pathways are used to accentuate changing scene and views. So as we saw in design characteristics, there are different scenic views present. There are different scenic sections. So the pathways are used to accentuate them. The pathways are of different width and materials, which represent different aspects such as constriction, roughness, release, and smoothness. Then the fifth design element is bridges. It is used to connect two different vistas. Then Moon Bridge is an example of a bridge in Chinese gardens. Then the sixth element is structures. Structures such as walkways, pavilions, kiosk, pagoda, wall, and two-story tower for views can be seen in Chinese gardens. So the next category is types and examples. There are two types of Chinese gardens, imperial style gardens, then the second one is scholarly style or private gardens. And a few notable examples are humble administrators gardens in Suzhou, garden for lingering also in Suzhou, then imperial summer palace in Beijing, imperial mountain resort in Chengde, then Beihai Park in Beijing. So these are five examples of Chinese gardens. So this concludes the topic of Chinese gardens. Now moving on to the next garden. Okay, so the second type of gardens are English gardens, another important type of gardens. So let's see, have a look at their introduction. So the English gardens appreciate and value the natural world. They are inspired from paintings of landscape by Claude Lorraine and Nicolas Poussin, who were landscape painters. So the gardens are inspired from their paintings. So a question can come, which type of gardens are inspired from paintings? The answer would be English gardens. Now, the English gardens present an idealized view of nature and the notion of being picturesque. Where did we hear this word? We heard this in the previous video when we were talking about William Kent, who is the pioneer of picturesque. Now, the second category is design characteristics. In my research, I could not find much about design characteristics, or I could not find enough information that I could put in this heading. So some of the generic heading is talking about landform, the hardscape, softscape and water in English gardens. Now the main thing that we will discuss in this is design elements. So design elements. So there are 13 main elements in English gardens. So quite a lot. So pay attention. The first one is follies. What are follies? They are recreation of classical buildings. So they are essentially fake buildings in the garden. So the second main element is grottos. It is a romantic hideout in the garden where the couples do the
devil's tango.
And it resembles a dark natural cave. So the third element is haha walls. Haha walls are special walls that separates garden from grazing land. Because of this, there is no need of hedges or fences that usually block views. You can have a continuous view of the garden. The haha wall also provide cattle security. So what a surprise. We didn't know that the Englishmen were gaurakshaks. Then the fourth element is rolling lawns. They are mounds and niches and act as a surprise element to the viewer who is in the garden. The fifth element is tree groves. There is mass tree plantation which is widespread and it is used for wandering. So one can get lost in them. The sixth element is beescape, so there is bee farming, you can say that. Then the seventh one is wattle edging and panels, some of them made from bamboo. The ninth element is ruins. There are many structures which look like dilapidated ruins. Then the tenth one is lake. There is always a lake in English gardens and it appears natural even though it is man-made. The edges of the lakes are meandering and irregular, and there is always pathways close to the water edge. The 11th element is bridges. The 12th is natural stone, 13th cobblestone, and 14th, which is a bonus one, is that there are lawns in English garden. So this is one key thing that separates from the Chinese gardens. Both are talking about naturalistic feeling, but there are lawns in English gardens, so this is a nice difference. Now moving on to the next category. So the fourth category is types and examples. So there are no types, but there are examples in English garden. So the first example is garden of Rousham House in Oxfordshire. As we know, William Kent designed it, we discussed in the previous video. Then Chiswick House in London, Stowe House in Buckinghamshire, Stourhead in Wiltshire, and Chatsworth House in Derbyshire. So a lot of shires are there. So I have a exercise for you. Have a look at which of them are designed by William Kent and which of them are designed by Lancelot Capability Brown. So Google and have a look and find out yourself. Okay, now moving on to the next garden. So the third type of garden is French gardens. So let's have a look at their introduction. So the French gardens are inspired by Italian Renaissance gardens. They are a type of Baroque gardens. The philosophy behind French garden is symmetry and imposing order on nature. So this is a key difference between the French garden and Chinese garden, or even English gardens, where they try to be in harmony with nature, whereas French garden has a very different opposite approach, is that they try to impose order on nature. The garden is composed like a painting and it has to be viewed or looked at as a whole, just like a painting. So let's have a look at the design characteristics. French garden has a geometrical plan. The house or the palace or the chateau is the central point of the garden. So the architecture of the building is also very important in this case. The house is always in focus. The house is the ornament and garden is there to complement it again. So it's a very different approach. Then the paths radiate out from the house, creating axial views. The central axis is always perpendicular to the house. Trees planted in straight lines are trimmed at set height. So when we were talking about trees planted in straight line and trimming, so that is topiary. So there is an element of topiary in this. No trees are close to the house, only low height planting beds. Also, there is a terrace to overlook the whole garden, which means that, again, which emphasizes that it is like a painting and it has to be viewed as a whole. So it is more about the view aspect of it, the showness aspect of it. Okay, so let's now look at the design elements. In design elements, so there are 11 main elements of the French garden. Okay, so the first main element is parterre. They are essentially a planting bed. They are square or rectangular in shape. The ornamental design in the planting bed is made with clipped hedges or flowers and gravel. The second element is broderie. So what are broderies? They are curling decorative patterns in the garden. They are created with trimmed yew or box or cutting lawns and filling with colored gravel, as you can see in the picture. Then the third is bosquet. It is a small group of trees as ornamental backdrops. The fourth one is allée. They are straight path lined with trees, so it's like a boulevard of sorts. The fifth element is topiary. As we discussed before, the trees or bushes trimmed into ornamental or geometric shapes are called topiary. So the sixth element is goosefoot pad d'oie. What is this goosefoot pad d'oie? They are 3 to 5 paths which spread out from a single point. Then the seventh element is statuary, which are essentially pieces of sculptures. The eighth element is follies. Again, just like in English gardens, they are also fake buildings for ornamentations can be found in French gardens. Then the ninth element is water. Water are in the shape of round pools or long rectangular water bodies such as canals and basins, and they are used as a mirror. The water is used as a mirror for reflection. There are also fountains and cascades in this French gardens. So it is different from, again, from Chinese gardens. They did not have fountains. Then the 10th element is trellises, and the 11th and the final element is bird bath. So a lot of birds usually come to French gardens because of their geometric design, I presume. They don't go to the organic design of Chinese gardens and English gardens. Then moving on to the next category. So the fourth category is types and examples. And as discussed before, the Garden of Versailles is one example, and the Garden of Chateau de Chantilly is another example. See if you can find more examples. Do this exercise, okay? Hey everyone, I hope you found this video about the different type of gardens useful. If you found it useful, then please leave a like. Comment down below if you have any questions or would like to share something. Then share this video with everyone you know and ask them to subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you get notification whenever I upload a new video. Theek hai? Okay then, milte hain fir.